Wellen. Do you like Rod Stewart?
Hi, Bob. He's no bad for his age.
Do you think I'm sexy? Aye, you're sexy, Nobby. He's coming up in an interview with Naga Munshetti. I like Naga.
You know, I'm so happy just to be part of it, because there was a point where I thought, oh no, they don't want me, and I was over the moon when I was signed on.
You've done the rehearsals. The stage wasn't completely built by that point, so
no.
Where were you rehearsing?
We just rehearsed directly outside Buckingham Palace gates, the main gates, which is where the stage is going to be. The other two stages were built, but it was funny.
Why was it funny? Loads of people watching?
Only the officials and cameramen and people, no crowds.
You said nerve-wracking. Do you still get nervous?
I will Saturday night, yeah.
What? How will you deal with that?
Well, because I'm singing a song that I've never, ever sang before. So that's going to be... I won't say what it is, but it's going to be nerve-wracking, because usually I like to rehearse thoroughly, but this time I won't have a chance.
Have you decided what you're going to wear?
No!
Well, this is rather lovely.
Well, this is a bit old hat. I just put this on because I thought it was appropriate for the interview.
Absolutely.
But
glad you dressed
up. I've got a few numbers up in the loft.
How do you decide? When will you decide?
I ask the missus. She goes, you're not going to wear that again, are you? So I don't really know. You know, it's I don't want to overdress.
So we don't know if it's going to rain yet. We're all keeping a really close eye on the forecast. You are very active on stage. Like, you run up and down. If it's raining, are you going to be doing that?
Yeah. If I fall over, I fall over. And I have fallen over many times. But you know what? I've performed in the rain many, many times. And it's if you make the audience part of it, and I go out and I get wet and the band get wet, then it's all a big party. It's gonna, don't worry about the weather. It's the least of our problems.
When you are on that stage, it's going to be so different with the crowds. I mean, everyone's just so happy, aren't they? And it's a celebration. Absolutely,
yeah.
Isn't it?
Yeah. It's pride. It's pride in being British. It's the pageantry, the romance. I mean, I've grown up with this woman. You know, I was 7 when she came to the throne. So she's always been part of my life, you know. And the fact that I've met her on several occasions makes it even more important for me.
Do you remember the coronation?
Yeah, we had a street party, a loaf of bread and a pot of jam. 30 people.
Did you see it on telly?
No, I didn't have a telly. Didn't have a television.
Oh, it's so different.
Somebody did have a television up the road, and it was only that big, and we all gathered round it.
You've kind of alluded to what the Queen means to you. What does she mean to you? You've met her on a few occasions. That must have been amazing.
Concert at St James's Palace for Her Majesty and the late Duke of Edinburgh. And they were only sitting, I had the band here, and they were sitting 10 yards away. Right, and they looked terrified because they thought I was going to do, do you think I'm sexy, hot legs, real loud music. And I started off, you must remember this, a kiss is just a kiss.
A smile is just a
smile. Smile is just a smile. They were so relieved, they beamed from ear to ear.
Who would you like to see out of the royal family getting up and shaking their thing?
I don't know. I want everyone to shake their thing. I want the audience to shake their thing. I'm going to shake my thing and you are going to shake your thing.
I'll be watching. Who do you think is most likely to get up and dance out of the royals?
Charles.
Why'd you say that?
Because I love him and my wife absolutely adores him.
Why?
See, I think they've got a thing going on. Oh! No, they're very, very friendly.
You know, I'm going to keep that in the edit. I'm going to keep that in the edit. I don't, what's Penny going to say to that? You saying that on national telly?
She's going to absolutely dive in. I wish I was dead right now. All right, I'm going home.
Oh, it's fabulous. Who else are you looking forward to seeing perform with you? Because you've got the likes of Diana Ross up
on
stage, Ed Sheeran, Sam Ryder from Eurovision.
George Ezra.
Oh, of course.
Yeah.
Why?
I'm looking forward
Big
to
fan?
Seeing him. Yeah, I am. We're supposed to be doing a pod thing together pretty soon, but I just like him because he's different. He's clean cut and just looks different to every rock star I've ever seen. His style of singing is most unusual because he's singing, I think, as a baritone. Great songwriter, and he's great. I love him. Breath of fresh air.
Is there anyone you wish you could perform with now
that
you haven't
dead.
Done?
They're all dead, mate. Sam Cooke, Otis Redding, they're all dead. Lady Gaga, maybe.
would be fantastic, wouldn't it? Obviously, you're going to be the star of the concert on Saturday night.
Well, no, Her Majesty is the star of the concert.
I sit corrected. Absolutely, you're absolutely right. But Penny, your wife, is also going to play a very, very important role on the night.
Yeah, she's a police constable, patrolling from, I think, 10 o'clock at night till 6 in the morning, doing her job, and she loves it, bless her.
What does she get out of it?
I think the feeling of giving something back, which I know is an old cliche, but she once told me, she said, I love looking after the city that I love. And she loves London and she wants to look after it. I phone her up and I say, anything happened tonight? Oh, we arrested a man in a car with some drugs and we took him down the station.
Do you ever worry about her?
No, she's 6'3", come on. But she has to go down the station then and fill in all the forms. Then she don't get home till 3, you know.
And then it's your turn to make the breakfast and tea in bed.
I do, actually, I do. Don't laugh, I do.
I don't need to do anything else. So, Rod, it's been a joy talking to you.
Thank you for coming all this way.
Thank you so much.
I love our royal family. I'm so proud of it. And may it reign for another 100 years.
Well said. So, Rod Stewart, it's been a pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you.
Absolute delight interviewing Sir Rod Stewart, and I know he's really excited. Two songs, so we were told one of them. The second is a surprise, and I think it will be a very big hit.